Like God, we too were made in three parts. We have our body, our soul, and our spirit. We can see this in 1 Thessalonians 5:23 when Paul says, "May God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ." Let's unpack that a bit more. First, let's look at our body. It has our blood, our bone, and our tissue. Next is our soul. Our soul is our mind, our will, and our emotions. And last, we're going to focus on the spirit. Here in our spirit is where we find our creativity. It's the place we worship from. It's our conscience, knowing right from wrong. And our identity, who God created us to be. Today we're going to look at what happens when we experience things in our lives and past that can cause a crushing to our spirit. So what are these things? Well, abuse of any kind, trauma, big or small, neglect, bullying. These events and moments in our lives often become a heavy burden or weight and can crush us. And they don't just crush us physically. The weight of those events we saw can crush our creativity and identity, which might cause us to believe that we are not creative and that who we are is not good enough. So what do we do with the weight, the trauma, abuse, or bullying? Well, there is only one who can take it. Jesus reaches out his hands and meets us in the abuse, the trauma, and the bullying and lifts the weight, defilement, shame, hurt, so we can begin to experience freedom. And when the freedom comes, we may experience God's truth goes even deeper and brings life to us in a new way. What used to feel hard or dry becomes a place of new growth. Because who the Son sets free is free indeed.